This is our sample application. We've got a function to delay things until after the event loop. So this, for example, will print debug info after everything else executes. It's just a way to delay the debug info. This is a function constructor. We've got a hint to convert it to a class. We'll ignore that for now. There's a print method on this to print the contact details. We have a contact list, which has its own print function. It says about to print, then iterates the contacts. There's a find function that allows us to pass a test and returns the item that matches the test. Then I create a contact with me and Doreen, put it into a list and print that. Then I try to find this entry. You can see the name matches here, name, found something, not found. Now there's no errors indicated here. Let's go ahead and open a console and run this. See what happens. And as you can see, nothing prints, nothing found, no exceptions thrown, but our code isn't working. So the first thing I want to do is convert this to TypeScript. And you've heard the expression, valid JavaScript is valid TypeScript. Let's go ahead and test that. I'm going to initialize an NPM project. So that just sets up our package JSON. Then I'm going to install the TypeScript tools. And once that's installed, I'm going to just edit the script so that we can have a build script that calls the compiler and a build script with a watch that calls the compiler with a watch function. The last thing I need to do is initialize the TypeScript configuration. So what we'll do is we'll go node modules, TypeScript, bin, tsc, init. That'll initialize a new package. You can see this package appears here. And then our very last step is we're going to rename this as TypeScript. Now when we open this, we have a ton of errors, and I'll talk about why in the next installment.